हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू द साइंस हब। दिस इज प्रियम कंसारा एंड इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल टॉक अबाउट मेडिकल ज्यूरिसप्रूडेंस। सो फर्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट सब पोइना। सो सब पोइना दैट इज सब इज अंडर एंड पोइना मीन्स पेनल्टी। सब पोइना इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट कंपेलिंग द अटेंडेंस ऑफ अ विटनेस इन अ कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ अंडर पेनल्टी ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर डे टाइम एंड प्लेस for the purpose of giving evidence. Section 61 to 69 of CRPC deals with the summons. It may also require him to bring with him any books, documents or other things under his control that he is bound by law to produce in evidence. That is sub poena duces tectum. Section S91 and 349 CRPC S-162 and Indian Evidence Act and S-175 of IPC. It is issued by the court in writing, it duplicate, signed by the presiding officer of the court and bears the seal of the court, that is under section S-61 of CRPC. Crime number and name of the accused person are mentioned. It is served on the witness by a police officer, by an officer of the court or other public servant, by delivering to him one of the copies of the summons. The person should sign a receipt on the back of the other copy under section 62 of CRPC. It can also be served by registered post or fixed on some conspicuous part of the house in which the person resides. If the person summoned is in the active service of government, the court issuing the summons shall usually send it in duplicate to the head of the office in which such person is employed. Such head shall cause the summons to be served on such person and shall return it to the court under his signature with the endorsement required by the section 66 of CRPC. A summons must be obeyed and the witness should produce documents if asked for section 91 of CRPC. The witness will be excused from attending the court if he has a valid and urgent reason. If the witness fails to attend the court in a civil case, he will be liable to pay damages. In criminal cases, the court may issue notice under section 350 of CRPC and after hearing the witness, if it finds that the witness neglected to attend the court without any justification, may sentence him to fine or imprisonment, or the court may issue bailable or non-bailable warrants to secure the presence of the witness under section 172 and 174 of IPC and under section 87 of CRPC. Non-attendance in obedience to an order from court of law intentionally, that is summons, imprisonment up to the 6 months or fine up to the 1000 rupees or both under section 174 of IPC. Criminal courts have priority over civil courts. If a witness is summoned by two courts on the same day, one of which is criminal and other civil, he should attend the criminal and inform the civil of his inability to attend, giving his reasons. Higher courts have priority over the lower. If he is summoned from two courts on of same status, he must attend the court from where he received the summon first, informing the other court about it. He can attend the second court after finishing his evidence in the first court. So here you can see a sample of sub poena. Second, what is conduct money? It is the fee offered or paid to a witness in civil cases at the time of serving the summons to meet the expenses for attending the court. It is paid by the party that has called him as a witness. If the fee is not paid, or if he feels that the amount is less, the doctor can bring this fact to the notice of the judge before giving evidence in the court. The judge will decide the amount to be paid. In criminal cases, no fee is paid to the witness at the time of serving the summons. He must attend the court and give evidence because of the interest of the state in securing justice, otherwise he will be charged with the contempt of court. However, In criminal cases, conveyance charges and daily allowance can be claimed by the doctor according to the government rules. Independent medical practitioner may claim a fee at the time of giving professional evidence before taking oath, but should not insist or if it the presiding officer is not willing to grant it. It may, however, be noted that provision is made by government under section 312 of CRPC for payment of reasonable expenses of an expert witness attending before any criminal court. Payment of reasonable expenses of an expert witness in magistrate's court in summon cases is provided for under section 254 part 3 and in warrant cases under section 243 of part 3 of CRPC. So thank you guys. Please visit www.thesaihub.in for further updates.